48th stop of the IWWF World Cup arrived in Aqaba, Jordan, at the stunning Ayla Oasis for what promised to be an awesome contest.
Yeah, first time, never been. It's kind of like, I don't know, like a paradise.
Jordan is a beautiful country. I was surprised. I mean, it's almost 100% desert. Close your eyes and just imagine a paradise that you always want to be at, you know? And that's Jordan for you.
When they told me that I was coming, I was like, no way, really? It's not like Europe or, I don't know, United States. It's like Jordan. Really, I'm going to Jordan?
Blue waters, like crystal clear, and good people.
It's a really nice spot and we're lucky to be here.
It's a perfect combo, good people, good weather, and good wakeboarding.
The first ever stop in Jordan, held under the patronage of His Royal Highness Prince Faisal bin Al Hussein, President of the Jordan Olympic Committee, saw 56 riders from 36 nations welcomed at the opening ceremony, where a traditional reception saw big smiles on the faces of every single athlete and official, and kicked off the event in memorable style. The real action, of course, was all focused on the water. The cable, a brand new Rixon installation, was giving the riders a perfect playground as they worked their way through the early heats.
Some of the best riders from 38 nations just going at it. Oh, and he gets up. So you can see the excitement, you can see we feel it, and it's just amazing to see everybody out here.
Female and male riding, everything is changing in wakeboarding, and it's definitely getting better, and hopefully we can make it an Olympic sport.
For many, this trip was their first ever experience of Jordan, and the organisers were keen to make sure everyone got a real taste of some of the culture this amazing country is famous for.
Hi, everybody.
We're here at the IWWF World Cup in Petra, Jordan, to check out this beautiful old city. Really impressive, so what do you think?
It's insane. It's actually so impressive to be here. I've never been here, and actually I never seen a photo or a video of it, and to be here at this place right now with everyone is pretty magical.
You're so like a camel whisperer. Look at the photo.
We made it, boys.
See, they're old enough.
Perfect.
Welcome to Petra, the home of Indiana Jones. I'm here with Steph Collar, and we're having the best time ever. Jordan has been unbelievable.
It's been pretty much the best World Cup. Well, definitely the best World Cup I've ever been to.
Yeah, and hands down. It was awesome. So much fun. We went swimming in the Red Sea.
Played golf.
Yeah. We went scuba diving. We're at Petra, and then we're going to go to Wadi Rum, which is apparently the home of Star Wars, where, you know, Anakin Skywalker, he's pretty sweet. He just zooms through the desert there, and then he becomes the Darth Vader, and that's terrible.
And then we're going to have like a sunset camp dinner or something.
Yeah.
Sounds amazing, like a traditionally cooked dinner.
Stoked.
Back at Ayla Oasis, the women were fighting hard for entry to the final eight. The German force that is Julia Rick once again displaying her dominance on the cable. World Cup regulars Maxine Sopolets and Steph Collar gaining their final spot, along with Russia's Elena Rogacheva, Mary-Liz Seaman and Reina Carata. For the rest, it was a trip to LCQ, Spain's Julia Castro winning her heat, while Australia's Courtney Angus was delighted to have reached her first ever IWWF World Cup final.
This is my first IWWF World Cup final, so I'm pretty stoked to make it into the top eight. And yeah, it's been a bit of a challenge, but I mean, I pulled it off. I had to go through the LCQ, so I'd battle it out. I was up against seven other girls and only one got through, so the nerves were definitely going on that. You got one run, and yeah, I'm glad I pulled it off, and I'm here with the top dogs.
So you're with the top dogs, and you've got a chance to get on the podium.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, hopefully I can bring it home for Australia.
So there's the start list, the last eight ladies standing and some awesomely talented girls, as we head dockside to pick up on the final with our man in the know, Matt Crowhurst.
We're gonna send it for the girls.
The 48th IWWF Wakeboard World Cup, and for the very first time we are in Jordan at this stunning resort, the Ayla Oasis in Aqaba, the B12 Beach Club playing host to this Cable Wakeboarding World Cup. And Courtney Angus, the Australian legend in the world of sport so far right now, well known for her rail riding and kicker hitting, not so well known for her air tricks, but you wouldn't have thought that from the performance we're seeing right now in her very first run at her very first final of any Wakeboard World Cup. There's that rail riding skill. She goes 360 on into a nose press, 180 back out the other way. Up onto the transfer from box to handrail, full 360 to backside 50-50. There's that aerial skills, no wake needed there whatsoever. With the Bel Air, she launches skyward for a crypt, going right foot forward, landing left foot forward. Right at the end of this first run now, first of two, and she finishes up with a toe side 540. A little bit of free spin on the kicker, but that aside, a very, very clean way to start her finals attack. Julia Castro Christiansen on the water. We can see that left knee braced up. It's kind of a staple part of any wakeboarder's outfit. There is a lot of pounding on the knees, especially from riders at this level who do charge. So we go spin off the kicker into a heelside front flip from the corner number one. She goes Rayleigh just before the next corner, coming round. It's back straight now onto the box. She rides up the incline into a back flip and continues that rotation. Then she does 90 on, 180 off from box to transfer rail. Coming inside the cable now for the last little straight before the drive tower. Huge inward roll to revert or half cab roll, depending on the foot forward she is. Believing that she is a righty from what we've seen so far. So now coming in switch to the last of her tricks. It's the kicker that sees, oh, a cab 540, a little stutter, but muscles her way out of it for a good clean run. No wasting any time whatsoever. We go Australia, Spain, now to Russia. It is Elena Lelik Rogacheva with a big backside spin to get things going. She comes into corner one, uses the tension after that first corner between that and the second for a blind judge. Then she goes inside the cable for a half cab roll. That's a back roll with a 180. She goes 270 on, coming off a little bit early, but a nice bit of pressing on the tail. Barely staple transfer, backside board slide, and then rotating out. There's a half cab front flip inside the cable. Just enough time to get back out towards the drive tower for a back roll, squeezing one last invert in before she makes her way to her final hit, going inside just like the other girls for just like we saw from Julia Castro Christensen, the half cap five. Now we move on to, well, one of the biggest names in cable wakeboarding in both men's and females riding. It is this girl, Maxine Sapulet, Netherlands. She has ruled the roost in cable wakeboarding for a very long time, always finding herself on the podium at every single one of the major events across the world. Can she do the same again today? She's in yet another final. Lovely little steeze right there. Early handle pass, but delays the rotation. She goes backside 270 into a 50-50. Oh, that was not the usual pop that we see from Maxine. That is more like it. She goes for a bee sting. That is an S-bend with a 180 on the end of it. A Vulcan, but with a grab. First coined that phrase by young Nick Davies, the English phenom. There we see the rest of the ladies watching on. So that is Maxine's job done. We move on to our next rider, and that is going to be Steph Callett from the UK. This young lady from the UK has had a whirlwind of a World Cup career so far. She has been at every single one of the Cable Wakeboard World Cups, and she's finding herself at yet another one here in Jordan with us today. Can she do what she has done before and get a nice top spot finish in this particular 48th World Cup from the IWWF? Good couple of inverts first. Oh, lovely bit of rail riding style right there. 180 into tail, rotates back out. She gets a little cheeky melon grab in there. She transfers from box into a backside board slide. She goes inside for a switch crypt. Needs to handle the slack, move back outside the cable. There we see the back roll. What is really interesting about this particular setup is that it's a quite compact cable, meaning that the riders are getting judged straight off the dock, the kicker being the start of their run and the end of the run, and the end of the run for Steph there being signified by that heel side, front side, 360. 38 countries at this year's World Cup here in Jordan, which is an incredible feat for the IWWF. And one of those countries is Japan, and that is in the form of Reina Kurada, who's charging out there with a beautiful blind judge. Just as she moves around to the back straight, she goes kind of into a front board, but a little bit more than a front board, rotates that 180, keeps on rotating out, comes right foot forward, little shifty from box to transfer rail, back board, then comes out right foot forward, huge heel side cut, dropping out of the sky from that back roll. She comes around the drive tower into her final maneuver. She's going inside the cable, all over the tail on that toe side edge, almost getting stretched out the front. It's a front side 540. There was no pre-spin, and it was definitely a nice juicy bit of height on that for her. Reina Kurada having a killer first run. We now move on to the very first run of our Estonian finalist. It is Marilise Simon. She's coming in left foot, right foot forward to the inside cable hit, toe side backside 360, going for the little tickle. That's the first of our ladies to have thrown that particular style of rotation. We've seen backside off heels, we've seen front side rotations, but not toe side backsides. That's a good way to start, and a lovely first aerial into that first corner. She goes outside the cable with a roll to revert, comes inside the cable, left foot forward, 270 on, 270 off, rotating all the way through from start to finish, right foot forward to transfer, back forward. Instead of going to the down part of that rail, she hits the horizontal. She goes inside the cable for the slow-mo action with the half cab roll, the equal and opposite of the roll to revert we've already seen. Blind judge, perfectly timed into the drive tower. She lands, gets the handle just as the carrier clicks, goes outside the cable, but a big old 540 off her heel side edge. That is some solidly aggressive riding from the Estonian, Marilise Simon. Now, as you'd expect, moving into the final, who would be the last off the dock? Well, it's got to be Julia Rick from Germany. Last off the dock because she qualified first, as is often the case. And is it going to be another first for her? Now, could Julia look any more lackadaisical and cool as custard as she goes any more stratospheric than that? Front to Flaky with a big old grab on the second half of that. She goes into a nice 180 on, holds the handlebars, holds the position. Then she goes backside 360, backside 180 off, comes inside the cable. Big old half cab roll. She got that done nice and early, so plenty of time as she times it for the last possible minute for the most possible pop. She goes 313. That's the air Rayleigh with a big old frontside 360 on the end of it. Now, I mean, unofficially, of course, but it looks like even if she falls on this particular, well, that was the commentator's kiss of death, if ever there was. I was going to say, even if she falls, I would hazard a guess that that puts her in the top spot after these first runs. And there we have it, confirmation of exactly that. Julia Rick takes first blood with those first passes from our girls in this final of the 48th IWWF Wakeboard World Cup. And so it is, Julia Castro Christensen of Spain to start things off for the second runs in this final. And it means that she got last place after the first runs, which also means she's got absolutely nothing to lose right here and now. as she battles it out to move up the rankings from eighth place to, well, I'm sure she's hoping, a podium spot. Lovely hit with the kicker. Lovely air trick into the corner. A little bit wobbly right there on the blind judge. Looking solid there. Nice handle pass. Nice ride out. Smoothly across. Right foot forward into that big old transfer, rotating 90 degrees out to finish up the 360. She's going for just the one maneuver between the last two corners. Oh, look at that, a big old roll to blind. She's obviously happy with that, a little smile on her face as she takes her time around that corner. Then she goes 360 inside the corner. Now, I'm fairly sure she knows that there are some very good riders coming after her. Now, I'm sure Steph Keller knows exactly the same. There are some very, very good riders indeed to follow her. But she is no lightweight when it comes to throwing down in finals. She's made it into the higher ends of the final standings at many World Cups before. Can she do the same again? A good, good start. Solid, styly Indy backside 180. There we see a beautiful blind judge. She comes round to that 180 to tail, 180 out, stalling the rotation. Rotating on, then rotating off, and not throughout. And the judges will really love that. What they won't love is seeing her come off that rail off the transfer hit a little bit early. There's the Rayleigh 180, the crypt. Oh, and she gets a bit spun out. She rotates that backside one a little bit early, gets stretched out through the back roll, and falls early. Always with a smile on her face. She will be frustrated, of course she will. But the consummate professional, showing those pearly whites till the bitter end, we move on. We saw Steph Keller, we've seen Julia Castro-Christensen, now we move on to Japan. It's Reina Kirata coming in hard on the heelside edge for her first kick hit. She goes 360, was she thinking about the 540? Possibly not. Then she goes S-bend into corner number one, taking it nice and casual round before she gets to corner number two. It clicks, then she's gonna cut out on her heels once again. That back end, that first end of any cable is super, super tight between those towers. So where you can get the most pop. She goes back to 180 and continues to rotate to finish off the 360. Hard heelside edge for a big transfer. Goes a little bit too hard, pushes her over the outside of the high part of that transfer box and handrail. Oh, that was almost a whiplashing situation right there, but she muscles that backside 180 through on the end of the back roll, and then she goes 540. Okay, we saw the three. We thought she was thinking about the five, and she does in fact throw that five. That's a great run. Maxine Sabalet now finding herself in the rather unusual situation of not being in one of the top three spots after the first run. Having said that, she is the consummate competition pro. She can pull it out the bag when the pressure cooker is on, and it looks like she is doing so. Please don't let that be the usual commentator's kiss of death as she rolls into, oh, that was solid. She goes full backside 180 onto the skinny part of that feature. Getting a little bit more height that time, but you can see a frustration there. She does not usually fluff those particular tricks. Oh, S-bend to blind from Maxine. That is going to bump her up the standings. Can she keep it together going into the last hit? She was potentially thinking about the crow mode. We just see the crow, which is a toe side front roll with a 180. She wanted a 360, but still, that is some solid riding from Maxine. Not her best, but that is definitely going to push her up relative to her previous score from the first run. Okay, now it is Maris Lis Simon from Estonia. She obviously had a good run. She ended up in fourth place after the first run. Can she make it any higher? She is packing in the air trick. She goes inside the cable around the back straight. Misses an outside trick after that, but gets straight into the box. Now moving on to the transfer rail. And I think, honestly, unfortunately for Maris, it is a rail riding maneuvers that are letting her down, where her air tricks are very handy indeed. There is that half cap front flip inside the cable. Then she goes back roll. Is she going to turn it? Yes, she is. Can she get the handle? Yes, she can. Oh, and she's pumped after that with one more hit left. Keep it together, Maurice. Can you go for something big right now? Yes, she can. She gets the 540. That young lady is going to be stoked on that pass. And definitely an improvement on her first run. Okay, it is Russia now. Elena Lelek Rogacheva coming in right forward, toe side, backside, 360, goes for the grab, but misses it, which sometimes, depending on the judge, they don't like to see. If you're going to go for a grab, then get the grab, or do not go for it at all. Now that is an S-bend to blind, which is not an easy trick, but it was almost an S-bend to a hospital visit. She only just got that board round, but well done to her for powering through. It will still count. It's a big, big trick. We've only seen one of those so far. The rider before, that was Maxine Sabalet, coming off early on the outside of the transition fun box and rail right there. She goes inside. We saw that from Maxine. Not as clean as that, though. Now for her last air trick, I would say, she goes blind judge. So instead of doing the S-bend to blind, she goes Rayleigh to blind now. Which way is she going to go? She's going to go right forward, outside cable, to round off her World Cup attack on that podium. Oh, getting stretched out, but clinging on for dear life to round off that second and final run. Just two riders left now in this final.
I got it. It's
all right. Yeah,
just to interpret exactly what's going on there. Courtney Angus has just found out, because of the live scoring that is on the dock, where every rider knows exactly what they've just scored immediately after their run. Courtney has found out that she is guaranteed a third place finish at the very least. And still, she can improve on that. She can push really hard with absolutely nothing to lose now to go for a top spot. Knowing Courtney, I think she's just going to go, go, go and see what she can come up with. Having made it to her very first final at the World Cup and now made it to her very first podium, this girl is going to be happy indeed, and looks like she is riding as such. Packing in the air trick, super solid, every single one. Big 360 on front side, then rotating back out the other way, pretzel. That is stylish stuff from her. Oh, she goes 450, adding an extra 90 degree spin. There's that Bel Air, just dropping that toe side edge and popping off absolutely nothing into what's a tantrum, but without a wake. And there she goes. Look how surprised she is, just popping that backside rotation off the end of that back roll. So it is just one of the two kickers to round off her finals run here at the World Cup. She goes inside it again. It is a toe side, front side 540, exactly as before. And that is a very, very pumped Australian wakeboarder right there. Courtney Angus is stoked. And we have just found out, due to the instant scoring that we see at every single World Cup, as I've already mentioned, that this young lady, yet again, is performing a victory lap for her second run. Julia Rick takes top spot, and Courtney Anger squeezes ahead of Maxine Sabalette to take the second place on the podium. So here we're gonna see Julia Rick. I'm pretty sure she's not gonna go easy, because the girl does not know the meaning of that phrase. She is gonna go all out yet again, just to impress upon absolutely everybody why she is out and out the best park competition rider on the planet right now. Oh, that definitely wasn't in her first run. And if there was any doubt, she has just stomped all over it there with that back mo 5, then all manner of other aerial tricks. She goes 540 to round things off. Another happy customer here in Jordan for an incredible Wakeboard World Cup female final.
And the confirmed final standings looking like this. So, just a matter of the top three ladies taking the podium. Maxine Sabalette in third, Australia's Courtney Angus in second, and Germany's Julia Rick once again claiming that very well-deserved top spot.
Yeah, I'm just so stoked about my win, the third World Cup win in a row now. And yeah, I just had an awesome week here in Jordan, finishing off with a great competition result.
I'm so happy with second. Like, I couldn't have put down a better run than that. And I mean, all the girls stood up their first pass, majority of them stood up their second, and I got second. Hard work pays off, hey. This has been a fantastic opportunity for me to come out here to Jordan. I've never been to Jordan before. I don't think many people have. And like, meet all these girls, and riding alongside them definitely motivates me more, and I'll just keep getting better and better from here. And I think other girls will too if you get involved with it.
Congratulations. Thank you. Well, that's it for the ladies. Do join us again when we return to Ayla Oasis for the men's contest to conclude our coverage from the 48th IWWF World Cup stop here in Jordan.